Hey guys, my name is LJ Mitchell. I get the privilege of serving as music director of Elevation Church, and I get to play keys for Elevation Worship. Just finished church, as you can see. Pastor Stephen just finished preaching the house down. We had a great time in God's house and decided to film a gear tutorial. Why not, right? Before we get started, I need you to do me a favor. I need you to click on the subscribe button below. That way, we can keep you up to date with all of the content that we're putting out. We just put out a bunch of stuff for Greaves in the Gardens. Keys tutorials, bass tutorials, guitar tutorials, acoustic guitar tutorials. You name it, it's on there for your church, for your team. If you're looking to play some of these songs, all the tutorials are up. So, let's talk about this gear. Obviously, using a laptop interface and let's start with the Nord. So using the Nord Stage 2, I believe my piano is the Royal 3D, one of the pianos, come to love it. So how am I routing everything? So my interface is a Motu 8A, have it routed to my laptop. This is my external hard drive where I keep all my sounds, that way it doesn't bog down the CPU, the hard drive on the laptop. And so basically I have a couple of lines running in different places. So out of channels 1 and 2, it's going straight to my Radio Pro D8. And then that goes straight to the console. I have that routed for just in case laptop might crop out or something might happen. And so I'm able to switch over real quick and still have the piano sound and can keep going. Also have lines 3 and 4 running to my Motu, and that allows me to integrate the sounds on my Nord into Ableton. Controlling Ableton and a couple other things with my Nano Control 2, and have it mapped to faders and have the buttons mapped to different delays and such. So on to Ableton. I use Ableton for my weekend experiences, and how I basically have it set up is I have all my grand pianos, my upright pianos, electric pianos, and then I have something that I call sub keys. So sometimes I like to blend a couple of pianos. So for grand pianos, main sounds that I use, Nord, I'll use Ravencroft 275 piano. Just started using that one, loving it. And then I'll use some of the Keyscapes pianos. For my uprights, there's the Wing Upright, Amber Upright. Wing Upright is Keyscapes. Amber Upright is a Nord sound. And then I have some soft piano stuff, some Una Corda, and then like a soft piano from, I think it's Spitfire Audio. Then electric piano, LA Custom, Classic, Wurlitzer, those are Keyscapes sounds. And then there's my sub keys, which obviously is, you know, I use that to blend in. Mainly the grand pianos when I want to fatten it up or, you know, add a little bit. Right now, it's the Giant, a Contax Giant. Then I have my pads, which are mainly for Omnisphere. I don't really have to do that much pad work because Aaron is a master and a wizard, all that stuff. Plug, he's going to be doing his tutorial soon real quick. So I know a lot of people are excited to hear how he kind of builds a soundscape. So. And then, so I'll take all of those keys and put them into a subgroup piano bus, and then my pads into a pad bus. And then on that bus is where I will put all my effects, compression and different delays and my shimmers and all that kind of different stuff. And then I'll send that to a piano out, and then there's a pad out. And so what I've done is I've separated my pianos from my pads. It helps out my sound guys just in case they don't need my pads, or if they just want more of the piano, they could just take that without blending the two. To be honest, I think the pads are a comfort for me a lot of the times, but that's just how I grew up. So yeah, pianos go out of 1 and 2, pads go out 3 and 4. If you ask average sound guy, he'll love you if you separate your piano from your pad, so it gives them control. And then I have a drone for if I ever need to just latch a pad and the key. And then reverbs, let's see. There's some of the reverbs on the Nord I'll use. Valhalla, I'll use that as well. My shimmer will be Valhalla most of the time, and then I have a quarter note and an eighth note delay. So that's pretty much it. Control it with the nano control, have it mapped, and then the last piece of my setup is this. It's a Hammond B3, it's the real deal. I think it's about 1974, 73, 74, and you can't see it, but there's a A122 Leslie in the cabinet that we have isolated. One other thing, people ask about this all the time. This monitor, right now it's playing back our worship experience, but that's exactly what I see. So it's a camera shot set up there, and it allows me to interact and just, you know, be able to see what's going on the stage, especially when there's like a choir and like it gets really, there's a lot of people on stage and I can't really see. So it's been a great help. That's my gear rundown. Hope you enjoyed this video. Do us a favor again, subscribe, tell a friend. This is available, great resources, and we will be putting out more videos soon.